All evidence is being considered in the trial of a white woman who fatally shot her black neighbor during a dispute over children playing in her yard. A Florida jury is hearing all evidence in the manslaughter trial of 60-year-old white Susan Lawrence, who is accused of fatally shooting an unarmed black mother in an ongoing dispute over neighborhood children playing on her property. The jury will decide whether Lawrence was justified under the state's controversial self-defense laws when she fired through her front door of her Central Florida apartment last June, killing 35-year-old Ajike A.J. Owens, who had been knocking on Lawrence's door. Lawrence is charged with manslaughter with a firearm and assault. She has pleaded not guilty, but the state attorney Bill Gladson's office states that if convicted, she faces a maximum of 30 years in prison. Taking the witness stand Wednesday was Marion County Sheriff's Detective Ryan Stith, who served as lead investigator on the case. Prosecutors asked Stith to read a letter that Lawrence had allegedly written to Owens' four children about the charges racked up against his mother in connection to Owens' death. "I am so sorry for your loss," Stith read to the court. "I never meant to kill your mother. I was terrified your mom was going to kill me. I shot out of fear." Outside the courthouse, Owen's mother, Pamela Diaz, told reporters she struggled to maintain her composure throughout the trial. "Difficult is putting it very mildly," Diaz said. "The amount of emotions, the disgust, the anguish, the pain, to sit there literally feet away from the woman who took my daughter's life. I have to dig deep within my strength, my faith, to hold it all together." Owen's children will testify at the trial, but they have not been in court yet to hear the opening arguments. Diaz said she wishes the children weren't being made to relive what happened to their mother because they are anxious. "If this is what's going to happen, if this is what's going to make justice, then that's what needs to be," she said. They are eager as well to see justice served, to have Susan prosecuted and behind bars. Lawrence was stone-faced as prosecutors ran what felt like hours of video of her being interrogated by police after the shooting. In the video, Lawrence told detectives she had argued with Owens before about her children playing loudly and leaving their toys outside her home, but she told police it turned more serious on June 2, 2023, after she confronted the children about the noise and threw their roller skates. According to the detectives, Lawrence said she had called the police that night to report that neighborhood kids said they wanted to kill her. She told police dispatch to lock her door and said officers were on their way. But before police could arrive, Lawrence said Owens began banging on my door and saying, "I'm going to kill you." "She banged so hard it looked like my door was going to fly off," Lawrence said in the video. "And I panicked and I was like, oh my God, she's really going to kill me this time. You know? And so, I don't even remember picking the gun up, I just remember shooting." During the Wednesday trial, Stith mentioned how he had conducted an investigation and revealed that there was neither damage to Lawrence's doorframe nor wood splinters. Jurors were also shown video of another investigative interview conducted days later in which Lawrence is questioned as to whether she had searched Florida self-defense laws, specifically with reference to the state's Stand Your Ground laws, prior to the incident. Florida's law allows individuals to meet force with force, basically ability that exercises some type of force, if they reasonably believe they or somebody else are in danger of being seriously injured by an attacker. In that same footage, Lawrence tells the detectives she'd seen an article on the subject earlier in the day and says they had it up on Facebook. "Susan, I think you know the reason why I'm asking that question. You're smart, okay," Stith begins to say, but Lawrence cuts him off. "Oh hell no. No. Absolutely. I know what you're thinking, that I looked up the laws so that I could do something." "No," she says. "Absolutely not." Detectives later informed Lawrence that only 2 minutes had elapsed between the 911 call, where she reports children were trespassing, and the second 911 of her to inform dispatchers that she shot a woman banging on her door. "From everything I've seen, it doesn't rise to the level for you to justify shooting through a closed door and with a firearm, okay? And I think you know that that wasn't reasonable, what you did," a detective says in the video. In opening statements on Tuesday, Defense attorney Morris Carranza told jurors Lawrence was fearful that Owens would harm her. Carranza said Lawrence believed in her mind, in her soul, and in her core that she had no choice but to shoot. The defense lawyer Morris Carranza said that Lawrence thought she had no choice but to shoot because she was in fear of bodily harm, which means she took those actions to protect not only herself but us as the jury too, because we are obligated to make a verdict based on the evidence. After the trial, Owen's mother, Pamela Diaz, told reporters what it was like to have to sit in the same courtroom mere feet away from the woman who took her daughter's life, really driving home how authentically singed this experience has left her and us as witnesses to the proceedings. A white Florida woman was convicted of manslaughter on Friday for shooting dead a black neighbor who, the woman said, had threatened her at her door, acting in self-defense after the man claimed he was attacking her. Last June, Susan Lawrence, now 60, reportedly shot Ajike, AJ, Owens, age 35 and mother of four, in front of her residence in Ocala, 80 miles northwest of Orlando. According to authorities, the two neighbors were allegedly involved in feuds relating to their children and all the other neighborhood children playing near Ms. Lawrence's residence. After Ms. Lawrence argued with the kids and threw items at them, the police said, Ms. Owens went to Ms. Lawrence's door and confronted her. Ms. Lawrence shot through the door, with one round striking Ms. Owens in the chest. Ms. Owens had no weapon. Ms. Lawrence could receive up to 30 years in prison. Sentencing will be scheduled at a later date. The six-juror, all-white panel, reached the verdict after a little more than 2 hours of deliberation following closing arguments on Friday. The trial began Tuesday. We've achieved some justice for Ajike, Pamela Diaz, Ajike Owens's mother, said outside of the courtroom to reporters after the verdict, according. My heart is a little lighter. While today's verdict can't bring AJ back, we hope it brings some measure of justice and peace to her family and friends, said Bill Gladson, state attorney for Florida's 5th Judicial Circuit. Attorneys for Ms. Lawrence had no comment. The case drew national attention in part because of the delay in arresting Ms. Lawrence under the provisions of Florida's Stand Your Ground laws, and because prosecutors ultimately chose to charge her with manslaughter, not second-degree murder. The family of Ms. Owens, through activists and lawyers, had called for the higher charge, as has Ben Crump, a high-profile civil rights lawyer who has worked on a variety of cases related to the Black Lives Matter movement. Mr. Crump and other lawyers working with the family said that Ms. Lawrence had yelled racial slurs at Ms. Owens's children. One of Ms. Owens's sons was standing next to her when she was shot. The case also reignited debate around Stand Your Ground, laws that roughly 30 states have on the books, which allow people to claim legal protections when they say they acted out of fear for their safety before using deadly force. Not only was Susan Lawrence on trial today, but so was Stand Your Ground. Anthony Thomas, a lawyer for the Owens family, told reporters following the verdict. She shouted and hurled an umbrella and roller skates at the children from the officer's report of the event. As soon as Ms. Owens was notified of the incident, she raced what the police described to Ms. Lawrence's apartment complex. At trial, the defense put forth that Ms. Owens was furious upon discovering that Ms. Lawrence had been yelling at and throwing items in the direction of the children and, when she appeared at her door, threatening to kill her, consequently alarming Ms. Owens. In recordings played in court on Wednesday, Ms. Lawrence told detectives that, as Ms. Owens pounded on her door, Ms. Lawrence said she had been scared for her life. AJ was pounding and she was cursing, said one of her lawyers, Morris Carranza. In opening arguments, one of her neighbors testified that she heard loud pounding and shouting, though she could not make out what was being said. She called 911, she testified, after hearing a loud pop. Ms. Lawrence did not appear to testify on behalf of the prosecution. During oral arguments before the justices, prosecutors responded that the door was locked and that nothing showed that Ms. Owens had a gun in her possession. Authorities said the argument marked the latest in a series of incidents in an ongoing feud between Ms. Lawrence and Ms. Owens over the children, which included disputes over where they had been playing. Ms. Owens's family cite the staggered nature of the feud and alleged that Ms. Lawrence had been trying to get at Ms. Owens from the very beginning. In an affidavit after Ms. Lawrence's arrest, a detective said she constantly complained about the children and admitted to racial slurs she had used toward them before the shooting. He had stated the reasons for not filing a murder charge in the case and that there was not enough evidence to show that Ms. Lawrence was in a depraved state of mind during the killing, hatred, spite, ill will, or evil intent towards the victim, and he would not allow any decision to be influenced by public sentiment. The Owens's family said it was not fair that none of the jurors was black. The Marion County Court Clerk's Office said the original jury pool of 70 included 8 black jurors. Florida's Stand Your Ground law made national headlines after police said it was the reason they did not arrest George Zimmerman in the 2012 killing of Trayvon Martin. He was eventually charged but acquitted the following year, setting off protests. Media: woman who fatally shot neighbor through door found guilty. Susan Lawrence has been found guilty of felony manslaughter. A Florida woman who shot her neighbor, a jike A.J. Owens, through a closed door in June 2023, was convicted Friday of first-degree felony manslaughter with a firearm. The jury verdict was returned shortly before 3 p.m. Eastern Time. Sentencing was scheduled for a later date, and Judge Robert Hodges ordered Lawrence to be held in the Marion County Jail without bond. As Lawrence was taken from the courtroom by correctional officers, she appeared to shrug her shoulders. She could receive 30 years in prison. "Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus," shouted Pamela Diaz, Owen's mother, after Lawrence was taken out of the room. "Today, our family can sleep a little better knowing that Susan Lawrence will no longer be a threat to our community, especially to my grandchildren," Diaz said. "Though this verdict doesn't bring my daughter AJ back to us, it does bring a little bit of peace that we have been longing for," she said. "I am very pleased with the jury, the prosecution, the verdict of the guilty," Diaz said at a news conference outside the Ocala, Florida, courthouse after the verdict. "I find some peace with that verdict. I feel that, although my daughter is gone forever, the children's mom is gone forever. But we've achieved some justice for Ajike." Lawrence's law team declined a request for a statement. That 6-person, all-white panel entered the jury box Monday and began deliberations Friday just after 12 p.m. Eastern Time, after prosecutors and defense attorneys concluded their closing arguments in a case that captured national audience. Baby murder case. On June 6, 2023, the Marion County Sheriff's Office said Lawrence shot the black, mother of 4, through a closed door in front of her now 10-year-old son. She had gone to speak to Lawrence about a dispute by an incident in which Owen's children were playing near her home. Lorsinks, white, was arrested on June 6, 2023, for first-degree felony manslaughter after she shot and killed Owens on June 2, 2023, in Ocala, Florida. She pleaded not guilty on July 10, 2023, and was held on $150,000 bond. "This verdict is a major paradigm shift in obtaining justice for AJ and her family," civil rights attorney Ben Crump, who represents Owen's family, said. "No amount of accountability will ever bring back the soul-felt loss this family has experienced, but today's decision shows that senseless violence will be met with accountability." Almost a dozen more witnesses, from small kids to county sheriffs, 911 dispatchers and operators, crime scene investigators and forensic experts, testified throughout the trial. Prosecutors sought a first-degree conviction because Lawrence gunned down an unarmed Owens through a locked door. MZ. Owens was banging on the door telling the defendant to come out, state attorney Rich Buxman said in his closing argument. A belief that a danger existed, such that deadly force was simply not a reasonable belief because the danger was not present. Again, that word of imminence is very, very important. It's in the law for a reason. If Ms. Owens somehow, someway would have busted through this locked, deadbolt metal door, come into her house, and started coming at her, the defendant may have had a right to shoot because then the danger would have been imminent. The defense argued that Lawrence should be acquitted because she clearly defended herself, having been in fear for her life. The law says you should only convict someone if you're convinced they're guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. If you're back there and you're deliberating and you're thinking, "Man, she had some medical issues. She did live alone. She had these prior run-ins with a jike. I could see how she could be scared of her," said Amanda Sizemore, Lawrence's attorney, in her closing argument. "And if you have reasonable doubt, you should find Ms. Lawrence not guilty because that is what the law says. And each and every one of you took an oath to follow the law." A focus of the state's argument was on the first 911 call that Lawrence made to report trespassing on June 2, 2023, minutes before she ended up shooting Owens. Witnesses, including sheriff's deputies who responded to the shooting, told investigators that police were en route to Lawrence's home before the shooting because she had called 911 to complain that three children, one Latino and two Black, were trespassing on her property. The locked door became a focus of the state's argument and was the subject of cross-examination during the testimony of various witnesses. The defense claimed that Owens told Lawrence that she was going to kill her and was trying to break into Lawrence's front door that they argued was damaged. The state zeroed in on this claim during the testimony on Tuesday of Lawrence's former landlord, Charles Gabbard. Gabbard testified that, before the shooting, he had repaired a jam on Lawrence's front door. He said after he had fixed it, her door was structurally sound, despite some cosmetic damage to it. He said that the door was secure and strong with a chain, deadbolt, and lock. On cross-examination, Gabbard said that Lawrence had not told him how the door got damaged, but that it was clear that someone slammed the door. He said that in any case, he was going to replace Lawrence's door at some time. Lawrence's attorney then asked him if the crack in Lawrence's door was substantial. Gabbard replied, "Yes." Susan Lawrence told detectives, "I really thought she was going to break my door down," Sizemore said. "I really thought that I saw the door moving. And I really believe that. I honest to God believe that is what she said. She reasonably believed that." We heard Susan tell the detectives, "I heard Ms. Owens say, 'I'm going to expletive, kill you.' I heard the door crack, and when I heard that door crack, I fired." Hodges said he would order a pre-sentence investigation as requested by the defense and set a sentencing for later. The judge said it looked like the sentencing that will take place well before November.